Alright everybody, what is up? Welcome back to another video. Today's video, we are going to continue in the fashion that we were last time, looking at Texas A&M. Today, we're going to look at Texas A&M versus LSU. It was the highest scoring college football game ever, I believe. 7 overtimes. What the fuck? I don't even know how that happens. So today, the mission is to watch the highlights and get a rundown of how it happened. All I've heard of is, you know, through some of you guys sending me Instagram messages explaining to me how it happened. I haven't actually seen it, but I can't wait. So I'm going to roll the intro. I'm going to be back here. And I want to say a shout out, another shout out to my man Brandon. This is your team. This is your idea. So thanks for the suggestions. Thanks for the subscriber starter pack, of course. And I'll see you in a minute. The quicker you're here, the faster you go. That's why where I come from, the only thing we know is Okay, now I was going to look at Texas A&M traditions. I apologize, Brandon. I just don't have the time, and I just don't. And you know, even today, like I'm just sitting down here now for 15, 20 minutes. Then I got to go do something. I'll have to come back, edit it, all that kind of stuff. So, you know, bear with me. I hope I'm doing it justice. That's all I can say. Texas A&M. Now, you do realize that from this moment on, when you write in Texas A&M to YouTube, the thing that's going to come up the most is this game. Like, this is going to be Texas A&M. This is what it's about. I don't even know who won, to be honest. But we're about to find out. So, we've got a full game highlights of 34 minutes. I think that's too long. We've got an ESPN highlight package. We've got Harris highlights. And you know what? We're going to watch Harris highlights. Just on the off chance that it's not going to be copyrighted, okay? For your sake. Because the last thing I'd want is to make this video and for you not to be able to see it. So let's go. Look at that lateral move! Was it just? I call that a right foot sidestep, motherfucker. Let's have a look at that. It was pretty nice though. Running back gets it. Where is he going? He's going right. But no, bang! He actually did a little stutter before he did that step, to be honest. Let's have a look. That put the defender off. This one, bang! Look at the lateral move! Let's go, guys. 6-0. Oh man, he had me fooled, that's for sure. Is that the quarterback? Damn it, he says. You've been mossed. There's no need to make those actions, mate. So it's 17 all, third quarter, and it goes to 70 something per team. I'll see that again. Keep that up. Too easy, isn't it? Williams slices through like a hot knife through butter. Bam! Oh! Oh! Go! That's the way. See, I don't actually know who won, and I don't know even who I'm going for, to be honest, but of course I have to go with I have to side with Texas A&M because of my man Brandon. So we didn't like that. Hashtag scoop and score. Gussed for that defender, I thought he had him. Listen to the crowd. Oh, what? Oh, that's why they went so nuts. It's because it's the last play of the game. We've got to watch that. 1 second to go in the fourth quarter. No way. Throw it up there. Okay, so this is the first overtime. Man, you'd feel good. Yourself. So we've got, it was 31-all, we've had two field goals, now it's the second overtime, and they've scored a touchdown. And is it, once you score, the other team has one chance to score, and if they don't, then that's it? Is that how they got to seven overtimes, because people just kept scoring? Let's find out. Actually, you know what? I do have to look that up. College football's rule change to add overtime in lieu of ties is relatively recent. Okay, if a game is tied after four quarters, the teams will play extra periods until someone wins. Each period consists of one possession for each team, the order of which is decided by a pre-overtime coin toss. Each possession starts at the defense's 25-yard line. If the teams remain tied at the end of a period, they play another full period. Okay, and a period is one possession for each team. After each period, the order of possession flips. So if you had the ball first in one period, you have it second in the next. Starting in the third period, teams can no longer kick extra points and must go for two after touchdowns. This is to try and help wrap things up quickly. But it didn't happen. How long can college football overtime go? As long as it needs to. Arkansas vs. Ole Miss went seven overtimes in 2001, setting the FBS record. And I believe that this game went seven overtimes as well. So that's how it went seven overtimes, because they only have one possession each. I thought it was like a 10-minute overtime period, and at the end of that, they were still tied. Another 10 minutes, at the end of that, it's still tied. But obviously not. Hold on a sec. Hello?
Nick Minnett.
Credit card increase. We got it over the line. Thank fuck for that. Alright, let's get back to this. We know the rules now. Okay, third overtime, guys. After this overtime, they can't use one-point conversions. They have to go for the two. So this is going to be interesting.
End zone. Caught. Dee Anderson.
You would have felt like you got it wrapped up right there and then, but no. They've got to get eight.
Short ball to the end zone.
Oh, what? Yeah, shake your head, mate. How the hell did you do that?
Here I am, Walter. I
make this catch.
Incredible.
I don't think that ball ever made contact with the ground. Watch Terrence Alexander pull his left hand down.
This game's a freaking a highlight reel. Those catches, the few catches after the overtimes have been insane. So we're at 52 all, fifth overtime. We can only go for twos, sixes and twos. Where are we? We're about 20 yards out. What do we got here? This guy's coming across, probably gonna block someone here. This fella's gonna slant inside. Where are we going, man?
Looks like he's gonna throw! Touchdown!
That's where he's going. Now, how did that work? Let me see.
He's been in the game. Here he is.
Oh, yeah. 44 slices through. I don't think they expected him to get it. He's behind. Here he is here. He comes around the outs, the back. Looks for that gap. Somehow gets through.
Looks like he's gonna throw!
Why not?
End zone, touchdown, Rodgers again!
All, sixth overtime. Here we go, 30 yards out. Where are you going? Oh, not again. I mean, the team, they must have been tired, right? They must have been real tired. That's why this offense is just score after score. Or, maybe they weren't, I don't know. That's my only explanation to this. They're just scoring drive after drive because the defenses are a bit more tired than usual, is it? I don't know, maybe. Maybe they're just that good. Here we are, 64, did they get to 66? Yes, they did. LSU, tied up.
Keeps it himself.
Clutch
it
with the quarterback.
Now it's the 2-point
clutch play. Oh mate, this guy, this guy is carrying his team on his back. Number 9 for LSU. Scores another. But it is first down, so you know he can. Get open. Let me see that receiver. Where is he? Is he this one here? Bang off the right. Give it to me. Thank you. Thank you very much. What a run. Too easy. Okay, so LSU missed their conversion opportunity. Texas A&M are about to win it 74-72. Good throw.
Outside the five.
Got it! It's Rodgers! The Aggies win the game of the year!
Wow.
The Southeastern Conference.
Imagine being there in the crowd for that long. And for your team to finally win 74-72. I've got to watch that play again. How did he get that ball? How did he get that ball? They came across and then they went back the other way, didn't they? Yeah, they did.
Got it!
Got it!
The Aggies win the game of the year in the Southeastern Conference!
Hard luck, coach. Hard luck. What? Why do you fucking... He doesn't need fucking... He doesn't need a sheriff to hold his hand. He's a full-grown man. He can get over it. Well, maybe they're there to protect him from his own fans. You never know what's going to happen after a game like this. Insane, man. That guy with the dreadlocks caught a couple of absolutely amazing catches. Right, well, only time will tell whether you guys can actually see this video and it's not blocked, but I pray to God it's not. And so, with that being said, I've now seen how the highest scoring game in college football history between Texas A&M and LSU went down. 7 overtimes, and now I know how overtime works. And yeah, can't wait for the next one. So, with that being said, I'm gonna go now. I hope you've enjoyed. If you have, hit that like button. If you wanna subscribe for more, please do. And I'll see you back here soon. Peace out.